The entire people of the world have lost so much at the hands of this system. And it's interesting looking at how we got here and where we're going and what keeps us here, I think, is one of the more important things we should be looking at. What are the tools that are used to maintain this system and to prevent our escape from what seems to be the inevitable? And really, the greatest tool that is used to control the masses and to keep us in the state that we are in, to keep us in a state where we are malleable and able to be led in the direction that the powers that believe they be want to lead us, is the divided state of our community, the generally divided state of our society. I mean, each country is divided against each other, and then you break that down, each state is divided against each other, each community is divided against each other, each person within the community is divided against the other people in the community, very often with their own families as well. And all of this is done by design. And even in the response to the system, the response is so divided because so many people have a focus on a particular rabbit hole or a particular agenda, and nobody is really willing to unite. So many people want to be the kingpin. So many people want to be the guru. And look, I can appreciate it. There's people out there that want to sell books, and we do need to make an income. We need to make a living because we all have to pay to be alive. But so many people are focused on what they may have written in their book and their need for that to be right and their need to always stay on that same pathway that they were on when they wrote that book. And they're not open to criticism, and they're not open to considering that there may be higher harmonics to what they've looked at. They're not open to other people's ideas. And very often, if someone does have a different idea, they want to meet with the person and have a debate about the topic. Not a discussion, but a debate. They want to go in there and hack each other down, and they want one to come out the winner of the debate. And that's not really a constructive way to move the topic forward. What it is a constructive way of putting people against each other and keeping the community divided. And that's a very unfortunate thing. And well, it may be an unfortunate thing, but it is an unfortunate reality. And we need to put all these differences aside. You know, something that I said way back in my first film, The Big Picture, back in 2008, was one of the most effective things the government ever did to hide the grand conspiracy that underlies all the other conspiracies was to create a conspiracy culture around it to hide the grand conspiracy. This is the best method that COINTEL has. It's one of their most effective methods. It's something they do every time. They will take a real conspiracy, something that is a real problem, and they will embellish it to the point that it becomes unbelievable, or they will surround it with all sorts of conjecture and innuendo and theory so that people effectively throw the baby out with the bathwater. And that's why there's been so many conspiracies interjected into the movement in the last 10, 20, 25 years, 30 years. I mean, it's been going on for a long time. There's so many things we can go and look at, but all it really does is divide the masses. What I'm saying is that people should be very, very careful of claiming fact on anything that they have not looked at and investigated with their own two eyes in the real world. Not stuff they've found online, stuff that they've gone and seen and worked out for themselves. I mean, sure, there's a great deal of good information online, but there's also a great deal of misdirection. And people need to be careful what they believe. You know, because once you go down this rabbit hole and you start researching and investigating things, if you start believing everything that you see, you're going to end up very, very confused. And what happens is that people will look into a particular topic and they'll take pieces of it and they'll believe that, but not the rest of it. And then they'll take pieces of another topic and they'll believe bits of it, but not the rest of it. And then they add it all together and they end up so confused and so convoluted because they're starting to place too much power in the written word. They're starting to place too much power and too much value in what they read in books and not enough power and value in themselves and what they experience for themselves. And that is a huge, huge problem, and it's a huge mechanism that has been put into human consciousness in order to keep us divided, and it is extremely effective. Now, I've often said, ladies and gentlemen, that belief is the enemy of knowledge. Be careful what you believe. This is an ongoing journey. It's an ongoing path. We're still figuring it out. All of us are still figuring it out. I'm 60 years old almost, and I'm still figuring it out. Maybe I'll figure it out when I die. But it's an ongoing journey, and I don't believe anything yet. I have my own ideas about what may be going on, and I put it out there for people's humble consideration. but I still haven't figured out the whole thing. I mean, what is this place? What is this reality? What is underlying the whole human experience? That is the eternal question. And anyone who claims to have the answer, I suggest you be very, very careful of. But it's about the journey, ladies and gentlemen. It's about the journey and what we do with this information that we're getting. It's about what you do with the path that you're on, the path that you've been given, the path that you create for yourself. And we need to stop arguing and squabbling over these finer details of issues that we really don't know the truth about. And we don't. We don't because we're not free. And we need to establish that freedom. That's one thing that we do know. We all know that. We all know that we're not free. So let's focus on that. That would be a good focal point for all of mankind because the people that are running this world are very, very few in number. But there isn't really a great many of them. There's far more of us than there is of them. The problem is that we remain divided. You know, and we don't fight back, basically because most people are good people who don't want to hurt other people. And the ones that are employed to control us really don't think that way. They don't care who they hurt. And they wear lots of armor and they carry lots of weapons. So they are very intimidating, but we still have the strength of numbers. And all we really have to do is stay home and not comply. And we will change everything. You know, we're the ones that hold the system up, ladies and gentlemen. And people need to begin putting down all of their racial differences and stop buying into all of these divide and conquer strategies that the government is cooking up, like this Antifa rubbish, this whole anti-racist movement that is going on. It isn't an anti-racist movement. It's an anti-free speech movement. It's an anti-white movement is what it is. And it's quite interesting to see the amount of white people that are supporting it, because what they are doing is supporting the erosion, complete removal, actually, of free speech for white people. That's what it's about. That's what it's designed to do. Yeah, and the way it works is this, folks. You need to be crystal clear in understanding how this works. I could have a rally. I could have an outdoor gathering. I could gather people such as myself who wish to talk about this topic and discuss the fact that white people are being attacked for simply speaking out against government and speaking out for racial unity and for speaking out suggesting that possibly all lives matter and not just black lives. This is apparently a racist thing to say, according to the Antifa movement. But I could go and have a speech like this. I could go and set up a rally and I could have a platform at the end of it and a bunch of speakers get up and we want to all say the right thing. This is the way they do it, folks. They play both sides against each other and in reality, they control the entire show. It's all run by government. It's all run by people on the top levels, those who control government. And it's all propagated by mainstream media, which is simply a mouthpiece for corruption. That's all it is. It's just a mouthpiece for corruption that feeds the people the storyline that the ruling hand wants them to have. It certainly doesn't bring anything that is any semblance of the truth. And it's important that people look at that. And if you don't understand that's the way the media works, I urge you to please go out and travel the world and have a look around a little bit because nothing is the way they tell you it is.